try that again. At least I won't. You folks at home can try that at this level, but I don't recommend it. Griffin actually try it later on, like I usually do. I just did that this time to show you guys. I knew how hard he could be. The only way to actually really defeat him, though, is to get your Nova powers. Not Nova, Cold Dragon purple power things. Purple Force and Dark Force or whatever. Dark Force is Cinder's, Purple Force is Spyro's. You can actually get those without having to get all the items, all the equipment.
We are close to the surface. It's best to remain unheard.
But the one without the equipment is actually more powerful than the one that gives from the equipment. But the only way to get the equipment is to actually get to the final level and beat it.
There must be something we can use.
By then you want to beat all the elite enemies because they give you a huge experience boost, and believe me, you're gonna want that. And right now I'm actually gonna show you guys something special about Cinder's dark powers, shadow powers, or whatever you like to call them. And get this down a little bit. And then bad guys appear, we hit them with that. Just watch, folks. They attack each other. The enemy's in any range, they attack them. If not, they just stand around. Cinder's the only one to actually open the door. So first we gotta get some more ring crystals in her. I'll use actually Tornado on this one. Same thing. Oh, come on. You're kidding me, right? Okay. We do team regular wins. So apparently, Tornado's not able to be used because it takes up too much of your mana. Yes, if you don't press square enough, Cinder gets eaten and so do you. And then you have to start that sequence all over again. Thing is, Cinder looks like a bat. Spyro wasn't, so you're not really sure if Cinder is a dragon at first.
What was that?
Oh, if you saw that thing, you would be sure.
We'll follow the river. It will lead us to shelter where we can rest. And then we're off to Warfang, the Dragon City, where Ignitus will be expecting us.
There, I actually have been the game with a perfect 100 right there. My other save profile, but I'm going to be doing a new one here. So you guys can actually see me play through the whole thing. Believe me, being 100%, it's a lot harder than it looks, even though this game has like only, if I remember correctly, like 12 or 14 levels only. It's not that long of a game, but to actually get 100% in the game is drastically hard, but unlike the first three Spyro games that were for the PlayStation, you don't get anything like special abilities or anything for beating it. But it's still pretty good though to do it though. Very few of you probably can see right now, so changing some things. see, this is the second level, second area type of place. Fly down here. As you all know, that purple light is a saving point. We're not going to go there. We're going to go straight to these crystals right there. Then since bad guys pop up here, we're going to be coming down here and fighting them. Folks, the reason this thing started to glow brighter is because those enemies were in the area, and then I just defeat them, so now you can use it again. And here's another blue crystal. I'm actually trying to get a 100% straight away this time, so I'm going to have to try to bear with me. Another one. Nice little slam dunk there, get some more supplies, and go off into the forest. I'm gonna use fire on these bad guys real quick. So I'm going to increase the brightness a little so I can actually see what I'm doing. Increase it to 30, see if that changes anything. No, it actually makes your screens actually better. Also, so that's good. I can determine where Mars is going, it would be easier to play this game. Sadly, no. Crystal for us to get some more power-ups from, and some red crystal as well. You know, we may not need it right now, we might as well get it done.